So what to expect in the next 60 minutes? We will be sharing some useful resources and what's new in SaaS security. Also, we'll be sharing best practices for monitoring services on SaaS Security API. Like my colleague mentioned, please feel free to share your questions in the question and answer section of the chat box. And we will be addressing those at the end of the webinar. So welcome to Monitoring Services for SaaS Security API. Now, today's focus is on verifying status for core, DLP, and wildfire services, adding alert notifications, monitoring scan results on the dashboard, viewing all open incidents, viewing all domains for collaborators, and monitoring and investigating user activity. Now, monitoring services on SaaS Security API. Now, SaaS Security API provides built-in tools, views, and search methods to help you investigate and monitor your sensitive data. These same tools help you fine-tune your policies over time. Now, before we begin this topic, I would like to share how SaaS Security API enables you to monitor your tenant. SaaS Security API enables you to monitor the availability and performance of services on which SaaS Security API depends. SaaS Security API continuously performs health checks for core service, DLP service, and wildfire service, and reports this information as status updates in the SaaS Security web interface. It uses color-coded availability, performance indicators, and optional alert notifications. Now, in most of the situations, you do not need to take any action on degraded or unavailable service, because the SaaS Security technical support team is continuously monitoring the health of your tenant. Now, verifying status for core, DLP, and wildfire service. Now, SaaS Security API monitors core service, DLP service, and wildfire service and displays service status and related details. A browser reload displays the most recent information. Now, to view this information, you need to go to Settings, then Cloud App and Scan Settings and Service Performance Status. You can observe the status and status details there. Once you move your cursor over status details to display information about the impact on your end users, what could be the possible causes, and what are actions that you can perform to troubleshoot and resolve the issue. Now, I will share with you what does status details and last check actually mean. Now, status means the status of the service. The impact, causes, and resolution depend on the service. If the service says it's up, it means it's operating normally. If the status says that it's down, it means that critical services are unavailable. And degraded means that service is not operating at optimal performance. Now, status details are basically instructions that help you understand the status and, if applicable, resolve issues with that particular service. And last status check is basically the time elapsed since last status check for the service indicated. Status checks are basically based on short intervals to ensure that you are receiving up-to-date status information for your tenant. Now, adding alert notifications. Now, we all understand that fast messaging is important in urgent situations, and alerts are notifications that aim to inform you about threats regarding a system and network. Now, SaaS Security API services can be monitored in real time through alerts. An email is generated and sent to the recipients by SaaS Security API whenever a core service, wildfire service, or DLP service is in a down or degraded state. Your SaaS Security API tenant will send you one consolidated email for each state in order to minimize the number of emails a recipient receives. Now, this is an example of the alert notification that you may receive. In order to add recipients to your alerts, you need to go to Settings, Cloud App and Scan Settings, and Add Recipients to Alerts. Then you can, once you click Add Recipients to Alert, you will see this page where you can position the toggle button to enable alerts. Then you can enter the comma-separated list of email addresses to which you want to send alert notifications, and then you can click Add. Once you click Add, you should be able to add all the email addresses. Now let's move on to our next topic, which is monitoring scan results for SaaS Security DLP Classic. Now, please keep in mind that all newly provisioned SaaS security tenants with an enterprise DLP license on any other platform, for example, Prisma Access or Next Generation Firewall, receive SaaS security DLP by default. Otherwise, newly provisioned tenants receive SaaS security DLP Classic. We are in the process of replacing SaaS security DLP Classic. All existing SaaS security tenants will eventually receive SaaS Security DLP automatically. You do not need to request SaaS Security DLP. For optimal system performance, SaaS Security DLP will be rolled out incrementally, though you can get SaaS Security DLP immediately by signing up for a trial of SaaS Security with Enterprise DLP. To request a trial, please connect to your Palo Alto Network sales engineer. Now, as SaaS Security API starts scanning the sentient application, the dashboard presents a summary of the scan in 6 panes. Now, I will share with you what does each of these panes entail. Number 1 is assets. Now, assets display the top violations by exposure. The exposure may be public, external, company, or internal, and the file type is associated with the exposure. Now, just let me quickly review with you what all of these exposure level means. Now, public means that an asset is public if it contains either of the following: public share settings, which means assets are found on a public repository or publicly indexed on Google; shared links, the owner created a public link, a vanity URL, or a password protected link for direct access to the asset. An asset is considered external if the owner invited one or more users outside of your organization to collaborate on the asset. An asset is considered company when the owner created a company-wide URL giving anyone in the company direct access to the asset. And an asset is considered internal when it includes assets the owner has not shared. Also includes assets the owner has shared, but only with users within the company. These users have an email address in the enterprise domain. Now, the second pane constitute of content types. Now, content types display 6 predefined data pattern groups and the total volume of content in the cloud are those data patterns. You can click onto each data pattern to drill down into the details by content category. Now, I'll just give you a quick review of each data pattern. Now, intellectual property. It basically means that it scans files for RSA and AWS secret keys and confidential documents that are at risk of being stored or shared in a way that could result in a loss of intellectual property. PII, personally identifiable information. Now, it scans for PII data such as US, Canadian, and international social security numbers. It also scans for tax IDs from the US, Australia, Canada, Germany, and the UK, both the unique taxpayer ID and national insurance number. And financial information, it scans for financial data, including credit card numbers, credit card magnetic stripe data, international bank account numbers, financial accounting bank statements, personal finance invoices, and other financial documents by default. Now, SaaS Security API performs strict checking on credit card numbers to reduce false positives. Then healthcare information. Now, it scans healthcare documents for exposure to sensitive or confidential information related to clinical laboratory improvement amendment, Drug Enforcement Administration, number and other healthcare documents, and legal. Now, legal information means that it scans for legal documents for exposure to sensitive or confidential information related to bankruptcy filing, lawsuits, business agreements, mergers, and acquisition information, patents, and other legal documents. And finally, malware means that it scans files using malware analysis to detect and protect against malicious portable executables, Microsoft Office files, Adobe portable document format files, and known threats based on file hash. Now, please note that hash is a unique fingerprint of a file. There's a string of letters and digits that is generated as a result of running a file through a cryptographic hash function. Now, the third pane constitutes of incidents. Incidents display the number of the active incidents detected against data pattern and policy rule violation for each content type. The fourth pane constitutes of users. The users display a list of users who own assets. If the assets are public and display the number of incidents associated with an asset, you can filter the data to view the owner with the most assets, most public files, and most incidents. Now, the fifth pane constitutes of policy violations. Policy violations display the type of policy violations and the number of new policies detected within the past week and the week that has just passed. And number six, the sixth pane is for collaborators. Collaborators display the external collaborators with whom your internal users are sharing assets. Now, we also have a part, which is number seven, which is for scanning cloud apps. Now, scanning cloud app expands files for the cloud app that your organization onboarded, and it summarizes the metrics for each. Now, total items is the number of assets which also display and explore assets. The internal users are number of internal users is defined in the domain. External users are number of external users is defined by the domain. Now, incidents are number of open incidents for that cloud app, and scan per day is the number of assets scanned for the cloud app in the last 24 hours. Now, viewing all open incidents. Now, on SaaS Security API, you can quickly find and view all open incidents to investigate and remediate and review a summary of the number of open incidents detected against each policy rule. When SaaS Security API starts scanning file and matching them against enabled policy rules, the default action is to generate a log when a policy violation occurs. If you enable DMAIL alerts for high-risk issues, such as malware or personal identifiable information compliance violations, you will also receive an automatic email notification in addition to the recording of an incident in the log. Now, what you need to do is you need to go on the SaaS Security API dashboard. You need to navigate to incidents and view all open incidents. You can then select the rule from the dropdown and further sort the open incidents using the columns. You can then continue to assess incidents or manually remediate these incidents. You can also review these asset rules that trigger the incident and configure automatic remediation. Now, viewing all domains for collaborators. Now, SaaS Security API identifies the email domain of the top 10 external collaborators with whom your internal users are sharing assets and lists the number of users for each domain and the number of files shared. You can use this information to determine if you need to change the trust settings or remove collaborators at the asset level. If you're an administrator or a super admin, then you can, if you're an administrator with a super admin role or an admin role with access to all the apps, you can easily change the trust settings and remove the collaborators. Now, selecting dashboard and viewing the collaborators pane, you need to go to select dashboard and view the collaborators pane to view a summary of the top 10 domain of external collaborators. Now, these are users that are not members of the internal domains you specified in your internal domains and with whom internal users are explicitly sharing assets such as file or folders. To assign a domain as trusted or untrusted, you need to select from the mark as dropdown. When you mark a domain as untrusted, the domain is added to the list of untrusted users. Now, to select view all domains, to investigate the domain of all external collaborators, this information is the same information you find if you navigate to explore domains. Now, what you can do is you can go to select external users or internal users. You can click the number of users to view details on the name of the users, the email addresses, and number of items each owner or user collaborates on. When you click on the name, email, and owned items or collaboration items, you can review the details about the user, including the cloud apps for which the user is an owner or collaborator. Now the topic is monitoring scan results. Now, as SaaS Security API starts scanning the sanctioned SaaS application, the dashboard again presents a summary of six panes. Now, we have already previously discussed this in the previous topic, which is monitoring scan results for Classic. So I'll just quickly go over them. So again, assets mean that display the top violation by exposure, which may be public, external, company, and internal, and the file types associated with it. Now, the second pane is for data profiles instead of content types. Now, what are data profiles? Data profiles display the scan results for the six data profiles that you choose to pin to your dashboard. You can again click to drill down into the assets by content category to see if a given asset generated an incident. Again, the third pane is for incident. The fourth pane is for users. The fifth is for policy violations. The sixth is for collaborators. And the seventh part again is for scanning cloud apps. So similarly for like monitoring scan results for Classic, even in standard, we can view all open incidents. And like I mentioned, on SaaS Security API, you can quickly find and view all open incidents to investigate and remediate and review a summary of the number of open incidents detected against each policy rule. You can simply go on the SaaS Security API dashboard, navigate to incidents and view all open incidents. You can select the rule from dropdown and sort using incidents using the column. And then you can continue to assess incidents and you can manually remediate them or you can configure automatic remediation. Now viewing domain for collaborators, again, SaaS Security API identifies the email domain of the top 10 external collaborators with whom your internal users are sharing assets and lists the number of users for each domain and the number of files shared. What you can do is you can go to the dashboard and view the collaborators pane to view a summary of the top 10 domains of external collaborators. These are users that are not members of the internal domains you specified in your internal domains and with whom internal users are explicitly sharing assets. When you mark a domain as untrusted, the domain is added to the list of untrusted users. Now you can select view all domains to investigate the domains of all external collaborators. This information is the same information again, which you can find if you navigate to explore domains. You can simply follow those steps again, where you go to select external users and internal users. You can click the number of users to view details on the name of the user, their email address, and number of items each user collaborators on. You can then click on the name, email owned items or collaboration items to review details about that particular user, including the cloud app for which that user is an owner or collaborator. Now, monitoring and investigating user activity is our next topic. Now, in SaaS Security API, you can view user activity across all assets depending on your SaaS applications. Using an API integration model, SaaS Security API connects to each service and retrieves the user activity logs. Please note that user activity is not the same as administrator activity. User activity logs is for users using your SaaS application, and admin activity log is for SaaS Security API tenant admins. These logs enable you to monitor and investigate a variety of actions taken by your end users, including file and folder downloads, file and folder uploads, fail login events, sharing collaboration. There are two different approaches to monitoring user activity. You can either monitor across all assets or you can monitor activity for a single asset. The workflow you choose depends on the scope of your investigation, but the filters and facets provided to explore the data are available at all times. Before you begin, please determine if any of your SaaS apps have any unique user activity requirements. You can also create a user activity policy rule to receive activity alerts. Now, monitor activity across all assets. Now, as part of your daily operations, you might need to investigate activity on a broad scale. For that, you just need to go to explore activities. You can filter the results to meet your audit needs. Once you filter the results, you can expose this data report as a CSV file to even review the activity logs offline. Now, monitoring activity for a single asset. Now, if a specific asset has triggered an incident due to organization policies, you might need to investigate that incident to determine correct remediation action. Now, please note that view all related activities is supported on Box, Dropbox, and Google Drive only. What you need to do is you need to go to Incidents, Assets. You need to locate and click on the assets item name. You can select who is accessing this file and view all related activities. Please also note that if there's no activity or no activity in the past 90 days message displays, you can again filter the results to meet your audit needs, and then you can export this data to a CSV file to review the activity logs offline. Now, monitor activity within a folder. If you want to view user activity or files within a specific folder, there are some cloud apps that support this view. You need to go to Explore Assets. You can locate and click on the folder's item name. Then you can select the events inside this folder. You can again export this data to a CSV file and you can review the activity logs offline. Explore user activity. Whether you want to explore the data set for activities for a single asset or across all assets, the filter and facets provided are same. I will review some of these filters with you. For example, date. Now, date is basically the time frame when the user activity occurred. Action is the activity the user initiated. For example, download, view, sync, share, upload, delete, etc. Now, by default, any activity log with action other is not displayed in SaaS Security API. To include all activity logs, please hover over action to display settings. Select yes to include activities whose action is unclassified. Then cloud app is basically SaaS application on which the user activity occurred. Target type is the location, user, or asset where an activity or change occurred. And search is basically finding an item using a part of the file name or find a user by a full email address. Let's move on to the next slide, identifying risky users. Now, just as you can assess risk by investigating user activity, SaaS Security API also enables you to identify risks by users. It's important to identify risky users to uncover the assets that pose a risk to your organization. For example, you can assess the risk of data leakage for untrusted users, external users, or former employees. To identify risky users, you need to look at your users from a number of vantage points. In addition to analyzing user activity, you can also identify a risky user in the context of incidents using the owner filter. What you need to do is you need to go to Select, Explore People. You need to apply a cloud app filter. It is optional, but it is good if you apply it. Then you can select internal, external users. You can observe columns for owned items and collaboration items to identify users with a pattern of risky behavior. You can click the value in a column to view the user's email address, any cloud applications used, role, and activity, as well as more info to see detailed information associated with that user. You can click the CSV on the report. There's a CSV icon on there, which you can click to export a CSV report with a list of all users and cloud application used, and then you can use this report offline. Let's move on to the next topic, which is user activity requirements. Now, SaaS Security API supports user activity depending on your cloud app. Please note that some cloud apps have unique requirements to enable user activity. For example, Google Drive. For Google Drive, you need a subscription to enable the retrieval of logs for Google Apps or Google Apps for Education. Without this additional subscription, only login and logout events are available to SaaS Security API. Similarly, for Salesforce, you need user event monitoring license to enable the retrieval of all log events. Without this additional license, only login and logout events are available to SaaS Security API. Again, for Office 365 and Microsoft Teams, you must turn on audit logs to record user and administrator activity. Now, that brings us to the end of this webinar. Please feel free to post your questions in the question and answer section of the chat, and we should be able to answer that.